I'm Guleen ma'am, your mathematics teacher. In our previous lecture, we have completed chapter number 2, part 5, exercise 2.4. Today, we are going to start part 6, exercise 2.5 and discuss about decimals. So, let's begin. So, let us start with the first topic of today, introduction of decimals. We have learned about decimal numbers in our previous classes. So, let us briefly recall them here. What are decimals? The number expressed in decimal forms are called decimals. Example, 5.2, 2.79, 8.435, etc. are decimals. Decimals has how many parts? It has two parts. First part, whole number part. And second part is decimal part. Example, 21.32. So, number written before decimal point is known as whole number part. And the number written after decimal point is known as decimal part. Students, whenever we read this number, how we read it as 21.32. After decimal point, we break the number. It will be read as 32. So now let us see this decimal place value chart. So in the center, you can see decimal point. It is denoted by small dot. And left hand side we have 1s, 10s, 100, 1000 and so on. And right hand side we have 10s, 100s, 1000s. 10s is written as 1 upon 10. And 100s is written as 1 upon 100. So let us take one example. 3684.26. How we read it as 3684.26. As I said, after decimal point, you will break the number. It will be 0.26. So, if I ask you, what is the place value of number 8? What will be the place value? Place value is face value into the place. Face value is 8 into 10, that is 80. So, place value of 8 is 80. Let us see here, 8 into 10, that is 80. What will be the place value of 2? 2 into 1 upon 10, that is 2 upon 10. Expanded form will be 3000 plus 600 plus 80 plus 4 plus 2 upon 10 plus 6 upon 100. Students, expanded form and place value is very easy. Whenever you get any number at top, left hand side you write 1, 10, 100, 1000 and so on. Right hand side start with 1 upon 10, 1 upon 100, 1 upon 1000. So, it will be very easy for you to write the place value and expanded form. Next topic, types of decimals. So, there are two types of decimals. Number one, light decimals. Number two, unlight decimals. So, what are light decimals? Decimals having same number of decimal places are called light decimal. Example, 2.37, 9.01. So, here after decimal point, how many digits are there? 2, 2. So, they are two number of decimal places. So, this is an example of light decimals. Second is unlight decimals. Decimals having different number of decimal places are called unlight decimals. Example, 1.12, 3.537. So, here after decimal point, there are two digits. And after decimal point, there are three digits. So, this is an example of unlight decimals. Students, note here, 5.3, 5.30 and 5.300, they all are equal. Whenever you add 0 to the right side, so the value of the decimal does not change. So now let us start with exercise 2.5. Super Demands NCERT book, page number 47. Question number 1, which is greater? First part, 0.5 or 0.05. See students, whenever we have to compare the decimals, your first step is you have to see whether it is an unlight decimal. So check here, after decimal point there is only one digit. And here after decimal point there are two digits. So it is an unlight decimal. We have to convert into light decimal by adding 0 to the right. So let us put the 0. It will be 0.50. And here we have 0.05. Now, next step, we have to compare. First, we will see the whole number part. Whole number part, both the sides, we have 0. Now, we will see 10th place, which is greater. Tens place we have here 5 and here 0. So 5 is greater than 0. We will write here 0.5 is greater. Now second part, 0.7 or 0.5. So both are in light decimal. After decimal point there is only one digit. So now just see here 0.7 and 0.5. 7 is greater than 5. So we will write 0.7 is greater. Now third part, 7 or 0.7. Let us convert into light decimal. So it will be 7.0 and 0.7. So 7 is greater than 0. Right here, 7 is greater. So students, 4 to 6 part will be your homework. You have to solve them in the same way by converting into light decimals if they are in unlight decimal. Question number 2, express as rupees using decimals. First part, 7 paise. See students, we know that 1 rupee. 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. So 1 paise will be how many rupees? We will divide. So rupees 1 upon 100. So if I have to convert this fraction into decimal, so rupees 1 upon 100 will be rupees 0.01. 1 paise is equal to rupees 0.01. First let us write down the formula. 1 paise is equal to rupees 1 upon 100. Then right here 7 paise is equal to rupees 7 upon 100. So rupees 7 upon 100, if you have to convert into decimal, it will be rupees 0.07. As the question says, express as rupees using decimal. So answer is 0.07 rupees. Second part, 7 rupees 7 paise. So here this rupees will remain same. We have to convert this paise. So right here, rupees 7 plus 7 paise we have to convert, it will be rupees 7 upon 100. So rupees 7 plus 0.07. So students, you all know addition of decimals. So after decimal point, here we have no digit and here we have two digits. So let us add rupees 7.00 plus rupees 0.07. So it will be 707 rupees. So answer is rupees 7.07. Now third part, 77 rupees 77 paise. So here rupees will remain same. We will convert paise into rupees. So right here, rupees 77 plus rupees 77 upon 100. For converting paise into rupees, we will divide by 100. So rupees 77 plus, let us do directly 0.77. After decimal point, there will be two digits, that is 0.77. So let us add directly, it will be 77.77. So students, fourth and fifth part will be a homework. You have to solve them in the same way. Just write the formula, 1 paise is equal to rupees 1 upon 100, then convert it into decimals. Question number 3, first part, express 5 cm in meter and kilometer. So here you can see the chart students, milli, centi, deci, meter, deca, hecto, kilometer. So before doing this question, you should know this chart. Standard unit of length is meter. Standard unit of length is meter. And if we go from down to up, means down is the smallest and up is the biggest. Kilometer is the biggest and millimeter is the smallest. So here question says we have to convert centimeter into meter. So centimeter is here, centimeter to meter. 1, 2. We will move 2 steps upwards. We will divide it by 100. So write the formula here. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 1 centimeter is 1 upon 100, we are going from down to up, 1 upon 100 meter. So 5 centimeter will be 5 upon 100 meter. So write in decimal 0.05 meter. So we have converted 5 centimeter as 0.05 meter. So now let us convert 5 centimeter in kilometer. So centimeter is here and kilometer is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 steps we have to move upwards. So right here, 1 kilometer is equal to 1 lakh. There will be 5 zeros, 1 lakh centimeter. So we are going from centimeter to kilometer, we will divide. So 1 centimeter is equal to 1 upon 1 lakh kilometer. So now what we will do? We will write here 5 centimeter and divide 5 upon 1 lakh. And 1 lakh, how many zeros are there? 5 kilometer. So convert it to decimal 0.00005 kilometer. So answer is 0.00005 kilometer. Second part, express 35 millimeter in centimeter, meter and kilometer. So students, first we have to see that 1 centimeter is how much millimeter? Centimeter is here, millimeter is here. So 1 centimeter is 10 millimeter. 1 centimeter is 10 millimeter. So right here, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. So if we move from millimeter to centimeter, chote se bada, we will divide. 1 millimeter is equal to 1 upon 10 centimeter. So here we have 35 millimeter. So divide 35 upon 10 centimeter. So after decimal point, there should be one digit. 3.5 centimeter. Now 35 millimeter in meter. So millimeter is here and meter is here. So 1, 2, 3. You will divide it by 1000. So let us write here 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. So now write here 1 millimeter is equal to 1 upon 1000 meter. So now how much millimeter we have? 35 millimeter is equal to 35 upon 1000. So now convert into decimals. So it will be 0.035 meter. So here we move 3 steps upwards. We'll divide it by 1000. So now we have to convert 35 millimeter in kilometer. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 steps we are going upwards. So we will divide it by 10 lakh. So let us write here 1 kilometer is equal to 10 lakh. 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 lakh, 10 lakh millimeter. So now write here 1 millimeter is equal to 1 upon 10 lakh kilometer. So now 35 millimeter is equal to 35 divided by 10 lakh. So now we have to convert into decimals. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After decimal point, there should be 6 digits. So write here 0.00035 kilometer. So I hope students, this question is clear. You should know this table. As I explained, milli, centi, decimeter, deca, hecto, kilometer. Agar aap neeche se upar ja rahe hain, you simply have to divide by number of zeros. Question number 4, express in kg. First part, 200 gram. So same chart which we discussed in terms of meter, same can be used here in terms of gram. Milli, centi, deci, gram, deca, hecto, kilogram. So here we have to convert gram into kg. So what we will do? First write here, 1 kg is how much gram? We all know from very starting, 1 kg is 1000 gram. If you look the chart, kg is here and gram is here. 1, 2, 3. So 3 zeros, that is 1000 gram. So 1 gram is equal to 1/1000 kg. So we have here 200 gram. So divide here 200/1000 kg. So 0, 0 cancel. So in decimals it will be 0.2 kg. Now second part, 3470 gram. So let us write here 1 gram is equal to 1/1000 kg. So we have to convert 3470 gram, that is equal to 3470/1000. See students, if you want to cut the zero, you can cut. So your answer will be 3.47 kg. So here I am not cutting the zero. So my answer will be 3.470 kg. So after decimal point, there should be 3 digits. As in denominator, here I have 3 zeros. But here if you cut it this 0, 0, so your answer would be 3.47 kg. Third part, 4 kg 8 gram. So here this kg will remain same. We'll convert this gram into kg. So right here, 4 kg plus 8/1000 kg. So 4 kg plus 0.008 kg. So we have to add this. I hope students, you all know addition of decimals. How you will add 0.008? You will not write 4 here. It is completely wrong. 4 will be written here, 0.000. Then you will add. Answer is 4.008. Do not write 4 here. 4 should be here before decimal point. Clear? So your answer is 4.008 kg. So I hope students, this question is clear. You simply have to write down the formula. 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. 1 gram is equal to 1/1000 kg. Then whatever number is given in grams, convert into kg by dividing it by 1000. Question number 5. Write the following decimal numbers in expanded form. First part, 20.03. So students, you have to write here places at top. Just to make our work easy, before decimal point it is 1s, 10s. After decimal point, 1/10, 1/100. We say tens and hundreds. So now let us multiply 2 into places tens plus 0 into places ones plus 0 into places 1/10 plus 3 into places 1/100. So 2 tens are 20. Plus 1 zeros are 0. 0 into 1/10, 0. And then we have 3/100. So now second part, 2.03. So places are ones and this place is tens and hundreds. So answer is 2. Let us do directly now. 2 plus 3/100. So students, here third and fourth part will be a homework. Question number 6. Write the place value of 2 in the following decimal numbers. We have to find out the place value of 2, which is underlined. First part, 2.56. So which place is this? Ones. So right here, ones. Now 21.37. So before decimal point it is ones and tens. So the place is tens. Then 10.25. After decimal point it is tens. So right here, T-E-N-T-H-S. So students, here fourth and fifth part will be a homework. So friends, that's all for today's class. I hope you all understood Kuli ma'am's class. So chapter number 2, exercise 2.5, question number 1 to question number 6 we have completed. Practice all these questions at home. Now next class will start from question number 7 onwards and exercise 2.6. So stay connected, do like, share and subscribe the channel. Take care. Bye-bye.